I'm gonna go down along the fence, sort of zigzag my way from the bottom up.
While Mike gets Cowboy Rex off to the prepper, the Harris's partner, Aaron Bolin, is on the hunt for their next big find.
We're out prospecting today, Tori and I. We're looking for new sites. Is there anything up here? We're trying to bust our butts here. We got a short digging season.
Wyoming's Lance Creek Formation, just south of Montana's Hell Creek Formation, is part of the same fossil-rich layers that were laid down over millions of years.
There's a brutal landscape out here. There's constant erosion. We need to make sure we don't leave something out there that could be a great find. A breeze would be nice.
A bone would be nice.
I want to cover as much ground as I can in a hurry. So we hired some new help this year, Tori.
Aaron needed some help before the ground freezes.
Some fractured bone. Yeah, it might be broken down.
I really love digging up dinosaur bones. I love being out here in the open field.
Tori, we got a lot of ground to cover. With another pair of eyes scanning the ground, we're gonna find twice the amount of stuff. This is the most important aspect of our season right here. I wanna find as many sites as possible, and then by each site I prioritize the level of difficulty, how much is in the ground there. This is all a gamble. If I prioritize the wrong site and we get to digging on it and there's only five or six bones in there, we messed up. We lost time doing that. Whoa, check this out.
What you got?
I see a lot of bones sticking out over there. It's pretty interesting stuff.
Dang.
And there's another piece over here. If I can figure out a way to get over there. This cut's pretty deep and a lot of mud in the bottom. I might have to jump over there.
Ooh, like a cat.
Sometimes you find these guys in weird places. They're not all just laying out in the surface. They could be sticking out of a wall somewhere. My goals for this dig season right now is to get the big find under my belt. I want to find a pachycephalosaur, a giant T-Rex. I want to find something that's extremely rare. Somewhere out there is my big find.
This is a really big rib.
There's a layer here where it came out of, and there's pieces of bone all through.
What's that sticking out over there? Can you see?
There's more in there. There's another piece here. There's pieces all over. And there's other pieces down in here. Yeah, I'm gonna go with trike.
Trike?
I mean, these are big, thick ribs. This is a trike. You know, it looks like good stuff, but it goes down further the list because it's so hard to get to. But I'd have to dig this whole top off just to get to this layer right here. If this is a T-Rex in here, then yeah, it'll blow the whole top of this thing off. But the trike or something like that, I'll just have to leave it.
A triceratops skeleton might sell for hundreds of thousands of dollars, but it's much more difficult to get a return on investment than a multi-million dollar T-Rex.
Now that I know that this site is a triceratops, it goes down the bottom of the list because it's just a really bugger of a site to dig. To get equipment in here, it would be a tremendous challenge. I'm gonna move on to find another site.
How far in do you wanna dig?
Well, let's take it off to about here.
All right.
At the Duckbill site, Aaron and Tori have collected and mapped out all the bones uncovered by erosion. Now, they're digging deeper, hoping to find the rest of the skeleton. And with any luck, a rare duckbill skull worth up to $60,000.
If I found the skull, I would be like running around here doing laps, screaming and happy. Plan of attack is to dig out the wall back here. So as we dig into the bank, what we don't want to do is tunnel in to get our specimen out. So we have to take off the very top of the overburden all the way down to the top of our bone layer. Can't rule out the possibility that pieces will be missing because they were eaten. I like to refer to the duckbills as the Cretaceous cow. They probably roamed in herds for protection. T-Rex ate them. But hopefully this guy was all rotten and unappetizing, and the whole thing's buried in here. I just hit a bone, and there's something right there. It's a good sign. So far, this dig is going okay. We got some vertebrae coming out. Now I've got 1, 2, 3. My hope is, because we're hitting all the vertebrae, that it's curled around this way, and that all the pieces are that way. There's another one. One more bone to add to the count. Every time I find a bone, it's like the little kid in me. It's like, I wonder how big this thing is. And then a whole site turns into a whole dinosaur. It just lights me up right there. So about ready to break this vertebrae loose. Here we go.
Ooh.
Oh! Looks like a limb bone, two limb bones.
This is the best part, when you get to the big bones.
Yeah, I see a larger bone like this will trap smaller stuff around it. But as we dig this mound off here, there's bound to be more stuff in there. Dig is starting to come together here. I believe we've got 15 bones now. We don't have a head and we don't have a tail.
Not yet.
The potential is definitely there that there could be a whole dinosaur in there. Jake, better hurry. Get your ass down here to help.
Here I come to save the day.
Wouldn't go any lower than that. That's our bone zone.
Let's get this sucker out of the ground.
In Wyoming, Jake, Aaron, and Tori have uncovered a large assortment of duck-billed dinosaur bones. They appear to be on a complete skeleton and possibly an extremely rare duck-billed skull. But after early success, they've hit a dry spell.
We need to find another bone pile like that one right there.
Absolutely.
Look, we don't hit anything in 10 feet, we stop.
I woke up at 2:30. I had a vision, a skull.
That would be pretty sweet.
That would be a sweet deal. Aaron really wants a skull to a duckbill. Still on his bucket list. Whatever I can do to help him find it, I'm all in.
I've done a lot of digs over the years, and Triceratops, I almost always find Triceratops skulls. There's an easy explanation for that. The skulls didn't have much flesh on them, so they didn't get eaten. So they just were left there on the ground. These duckbills, on the other hand, probably everything was tasty on them. So I've never found a duckbill skull, and hopefully somewhere in this bank is a duckbill skull waiting for me.
Bone.
Bone?
Bone.
Oh, you gotta get more excited than that.
Sweet. A riblet.
We're back on the bone. How do you suppose this poor little feller died?
They only lived to be, what, 30?
I think this guy died of sheer happiness. I just heard something. There's something here.
Got
sort of a round object.
Not another rib?
Definitely not a rib. That's a pubis.
Woo-hoo! Yeah, baby. Good work. Good work. I like it. I love it. Pubis is, it's like a butt bone.
It's for that undercarriage support.
Promise of finding a complete dinosaur, you think?
Heck yeah.
The pubis connects the two other bones that make up the pelvis. Because it's located at the center of the duckbill skeleton, it could mean there are more large body parts close by.
The bone zone. Every bone is leading to the skull, that's what I think.